Hi guys, my name is Shelby Downey, welcome back to my channel, and if this is your first time seeing my face, welcome. Last week in South Africa was hectic. My heart is so heavy and I'm exhausted mentally, physically, emotionally. If you guys don't know what's been going on in South Africa, I don't know where you have been, what rock you've been living under, but basically mass femicide, rape, murder of our women and our children in South Africa in broad daylight. Our country has taken a stand and we're enough is enough. We're not accepting it anymore. And as you guys know, I own my own studio, SheKnows Ink. So the other night I was busy drawing. I was kind of doing like a pro-female drawing kind of thing. And kind of inspired me to do something. If you guys don't know what the South African Rape Crisis Organization is, go check it out. I will leave their website link down below. They're an amazing organization. They help so many women in this country. And I decided that I am going to use my business to help. I have the means to help, so I'm going to do my best to help. So I decided to do a fundraiser. Today is Saturday the 7th. The day of the fundraiser, and I already can tell that it's going to be a very emotional day. Yesterday we did a few of the fundraising tattoos, and that already was so emotional, and I can just imagine how emotional today is going to be, everybody coming and sharing their stories, and yeah, but I'm excited and I'm so thankful to be in the position that I can actually do something to help. Even if it's just so small, it's still helping. And hopefully today's turnout will be amazing as well. And if all of us help in a small way, it's gonna turn huge. If you guys are wondering what the fundraiser is all about, basically 200 Rand gets you the female symbol tattoo anywhere you want, and all proceeds get donated to the South African Rape Crisis Organization. So yes, I am going to be filming and vlogging most of the day. Obviously I'm going to be tattooing, so I'm not actually going to be filming, but basically why I wanted to do this as well is just to remember all of our fallen sisters and remember their strength and remember that we have a voice and we need to make it heard. And every time we look at this tattoo, we're going to be reminded of that. And we're going to be walking around with bro tats of hopefully half the country. And I think it's so important for us not to forget. And having this on us where we can see it every day and the people around us can see it. They know that we try to do our bit to help and we're not forgetting.
So I had to do what they wanted. Hi, I'm Taylor Johnson. I heard about it through Instagram. My friend Benita actually sent it to me. And today we're here because this means a lot to me. I'm also a victim of physical abuse by a man. So this means something to me because I think it's important to stand together and support each other at this really big time in our lives. And I think it's a step towards something positive for women.
Okay, I'm Yasmin, and this whole thing's really important to me because I think it's so important to raise awareness about gender-based violence, and as a woman it really does impact my life quite a lot. It's cool to do things like this.
Yeah.
Thank you, Stuart. I think it's important because it's like a solidarity thing, especially if guys get the tattoo, ask for it. But, you know, it's like a thing that we're all struggling with. Well, not all struggling with, but you know, we stand together.
Yeah. Awesome. Thank you, guys.
And I think it's rather fitting that there's this drive today, that it's women supporting women. It's a good drive. It's people empowering themselves and showing their support. Uyunene's mother just made a speech saying that she's sorry, that she warned her about everything else except the post office. We shouldn't be having to warn our girls and women about certain spaces, be it a post office or be it a dark alleyway. It shouldn't be the case. And we should be supporting the weakest people in our society. And it's unfortunate that women have to be seen as the weakest in our society. And I just keep on thinking back to the fact that there's a 19-year-old girl in that coffin today. And why is she one of society's weakest? Why is her face plastered all over social media? Why is she the face of a movement that has had to happen? And it shouldn't have to happen. A girl should not have had to die for us to be rising up like this. So today is about women empowering women. And not just women, there are men out there too, which is excellent to see. Few and far between though. So I'm asking, where are the men? And why aren't they here? Why aren't they supporting us? Why does it have to be this way?
Hello, I'm Caitlin. I'm getting my little tattoo done today just because I've had a lot of friends who have personally been affected by this epidemic, and I think it just strikes a chord with so many people, and I love this call to action of actually do something. And I feel like a lot of us today just post stuff on social media and that's it, and we feel like we've done our piece. So I think if you can do stuff like this and create awareness in a way that's meaningful, then that's really important. And yeah, we should all be feminists, guys.
I'm Nathan Smith, and I'm doing this because I don't think it's fair that I have to teach my sister, my mother, and my girlfriend that they need to feel unsafe in this country around our men. It's time to take a stand. It's just not fair. It's enough is enough. I think it's just time.
Yeah.
Hey guys, I look like absolute shit right now. I've spent the last probably hour and a half, 2 hours crying my eyes out. What a day. It's after 9 o'clock and I just got home. I wanted to just film quickly before I showered and got into bed. Today was exceptional. It was one of the best and hardest days of my life. Knowing that I was able to do something that helped so many people, and not just the fundraising side of it, but so many people who came and got the tattoos, they had gone through some stuff, man. Oh, so proud of all the women that have this, that have the courage and strength to share their stories and speak about what happened. I'm so proud and honored to be surrounded by the people that I am. The support today from the event was, it was incredible. People had started queuing from half past 8. This was after 9 and we just got home. Like, by 3 o'clock we had to call capacity because we didn't expect so many people to come. I'm absolutely overwhelmed with so much emotion. It's been a really hard day. I just want to thank every single person that helped with today. My SheKnows Ink family, my parents, all my friends that came and supported. I love you guys so much. And thank you for always inspiring me and being there for me. And I'm sorry I'm crying. I hate crying. I don't cry. I'm not a crier. But today, oh, I literally cried first thing in the morning. We had like a little team meeting before we started. And I just started crying. And then I read a letter. I just started crying. And then everybody started crying, and then I started crying again, and now I'm here crying, and I'm not a pretty crier. Oh, I look like a raccoon. Thank you from the bottom of my heart to all the people that came out and supported and are trying to be better and to do better and to just show support and awareness and getting involved. And saying that enough is enough. I'm so tired of finding out that my friends have been raped and sexually assaulted. It's not okay, and it should never have even happened in the first place. And I'm so angry and overwhelmed because every woman right now is dealing with trauma that they haven't admitted to themselves or to others that it actually was traumatic for them, because society has taught us to shrug it off because, oh, that's funny, or oh, because he's my boyfriend. It's not okay, and dealing with that is, it's tough. Over 200 people came today. Of those 200, 25 were males. I'm so disappointed. I'm disappointed, but I'm so thankful for those 25 guys that came. I would just like to say another huge thank you to everybody at SheKnows Ink for helping and for willing to be a part of this cause. We worked for 11 hours, and I know myself and a few of the other guys didn't even have a lunch break. I haven't eaten since 6 o'clock this morning. Thank you so much to my SheKnows Ink family for today and for wanting and willing to be a part of this. We have to do better.